Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody.
Hey, Finn, how long do you think I can hold my breath for? 3 minutes? 3 minutes? Our friend Ricardo is coming over today.
Yeah,
he is a dive instructor. He teaches breathing courses, and he promises that we will be able to hold our breath for over 2 minutes to 3 minutes if we practice his techniques. Really excited, and then he's gonna take us out into the ocean and practice doing some diving and holding our breath underwater, so we'll see how everything goes.
Okay, I'm gonna go get Ricardo.
How are you feeling about free diving?
I'm not sure. I think I don't know enough about it, so I'm curious, a little nervous.
I think the most important thing of all this is nature. Mm-hmm. Nature needed a break.
It's so funny talking to people from Hawaii. They're so
down
to earth and involved with the land. And,
yeah, you have to
yeah.
be. You guys know what the meaning of aloha is? It means like welcome, goodbye, what's up, you know, come in,
yeah.
thanks. But the true meaning of aloha is alo to share, ha, the breath of life. So it comes from within, right? So when Hawaiians greet, they put each other's head on each other and they practice aloha, they share each other's air. It's a way to share one of the strongest forms of energy we can deliver to one another. But aloha truly is to share the breath of life, to share the good things of life, to take care of one another, to take care of land, to take care of the ocean. So this is what aloha is, and I think right now is the time that people are feeling more aloha than yeah. ever. The work that I'm planning on doing with you today, it's mostly connecting with your inner self first. Be able to really understand what's happening with your body, meditating, teach you how to breathe properly, teach you how to hold your breath, teach you how to read the signs and the symptoms that will allow you to take your breath hold longer and longer, and then take all that work into the water. Anyone can hold your breath for 4 or 5 minutes. Anybody can, okay? You only require a little bit of information. The more oxygen you have in your body, the more life you're gonna have inside of you. The more energy you have, the more focus you have, the more awareness you have. The way you breathe is going to determine the amount of oxygen your body takes. For example, shallow anxiety breathing, you reduce the amount of oxygenation in your body. If you now starting to perform diaphragmatic breathing, you're gonna be able to improve the oxygenation level. Okay, you're gonna take everything away from your mind and you're just gonna focus on yourself. They can take anything away from you, or the only thing they cannot take away from you is your own breath. With your left hand, put right on top of your belly button, push your hand away from your body just like this. That power right there is created by the diaphragm. By straining your diaphragm, you have a stronger respiratory system. In about 6 seconds or so, you're gonna bring air from the bottom of the lungs all the way to your chest, hold it in, and then count 12 seconds out. Activate, inhale, and breathe all the way up into your chest. Slowly let the air out, maintaining the pressure within the lungs. The hyperventilation that we're going to be doing today is a slow hyperventilation that will help you delay the urge to breathe when you're performing your breath holding here, and most importantly, when you're actually surfing. Okay? So we call this hyperventilation 4x4. You activate the diaphragm, you inhale the same way we did in about 4 seconds, and you open your mouth and let the air out, just like this. Activate, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, out. So, I'm gonna demonstrate now. So 3 4x4s followed by a full breath in order to enter breath holding or apnea. So, I prepare, I activate. All the way in, close your mouth, hold your breath, relax your face, and let it out. Awesome. is what it takes for you to take your breath forward to the next level. When you hold your breath, it's about recognizing the urge to breathe. For 5 minutes, 6x12 starts now. Your body calming down, clear your mind, the battle will be for you.
6x12 is the only way to increase oxygen content in your body.
Connect with the diaphragm. Love your diaphragm. On every breath you take, you feel it. Breathe in the freshest air right now, straight from the ocean. Appreciate yourself, appreciate your life right now through breathing. Only your breathing matters right now, nothing else. Now we're going to start your 4x4. Start now, 4x4 means I'm about to hold my breath. Let me lower my CO2 levels now. 4 seconds in, open your mouth, let the air out. Three more 4x4s. We're gonna be doing our first breath holds. Okay, relax. Final breath. Big one, all the way. And hold your breath. Relax. Three, two, one. Breathe. Six recovery breath. In and out.
Feel your lungs with pure, fresh air, all the way from the bottom to the chest, and let it out.
And hold your breath. 3, 2, 1, breathe. 6 recovery breath. Hold and enjoy. 1, breathe. Oh, you can breathe. Go ahead and breathe, yeah. We're gonna go further.
Dealing with the urge to breathe. 3 minutes. Breathe 6 recovery breath. Tell yourself that you are okay. 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Fully aware of what's going on in your body. Breathe. 6 recovery breath. 6 recovery breath. Breathe.
Like, when you breathe, and you hold your breath, and then you kind of strange a little bit, but then you're starting to relax, and like, you're all of a sudden, like, man, this is so peaceful.
Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah, like the first 3 seconds of you like going, okay, hold your breath, and that's it. Those first 3 seconds, you can take a breath so easily.
Yeah, yeah.
And once you get past that, like as you go further in, and you just lose track of time.
Yeah, you did like 1:15.
Did I get that far?
I think the last one we did about 1:30.
Okay. Did you make it to 5?
Huh?
Did you make it to 5?
No, he made it to 12.
These two just want to be movie stars.
Remember all those feelings you're having here? That's what exactly what you're gonna be expecting to feel underwater. Okay, the urge to breathe. You're gonna see how well you improve your breath.
I'm so excited for that.
Just based on what
you
learned today. As you swim, you breathe. Find the rhythm. It's not about counting, it's about feeling good at what you're doing.
Thank you.
Man, what a great day today we had. Ricardo, thank you so much for coming out, man. This was like, that was just such a cool, inspiring, amazing day. Totally learned things that I never even knew. I've been surfing for years, I've been swimming, snorkeling. Had no clue about any of this stuff existed.
It was awesome just to see your improvement, putting into practice through the breathing exercise, and you're able to hold your breath 3 minutes here, and then we got in the water at Shark's Cove, which is, you know, is one of the best places to dive in Hawaii.
It's actually way different breathing here on the couch than it's underwater.
Cool, it's a totally different environment.
Fear, yeah. Factor, like.
And the more we train, the more we improve, the more comfortable we're gonna be in the ocean.
Yeah, it was awesome. And you got Luke here to hold his breath for 3:45.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, thanks for watching Shock of Living. Definitely gonna be chilling with Ricardo. Surfing lessons and stuff like that. Thanks again for watching. See you next time.
Aloha.